Hi, welcome to a short feature demonstration video of the IPv6 prefix delegation functionality that Robert Lee and I have been working on for the upcoming release of Neutron. In this video, we're going to go over the basic setup and workflow steps that you'll need to get prefix delegation working in your OpenStack environment. As the OpenStack admin, the first thing you'll need to do is open the neutron.conf file and change the default IPv6 subnet pool to prefix delegation. This tells Neutron to use IPv6 prefix delegation for subnet creation where a user does not provide both a CIDR or a subnet pool ID. Next, open the Dibbler server configuration file and provide the IPv6 prefix from which your Neutron subnet prefixes will be delegated. In this case, we're using a real reserved block within our data center so that we can give our subnets and their associated VMs real globally routable addresses. Once it's configured, you can then run your Dibbler server. It's important to do this after running the stack script to ensure that the relevant network interfaces have been initialized. Now we're going to create a Neutron network and a prefix delegation enabled IPv6 subnet. Notice that all we have to do is specify the IP version and RA and address modes, and the default IPv6 subnet pool takes care of enabling prefix delegation for us. You can see that the subnet has been created with a temporary CIDR before a real prefix has been delegated. Now let's open up Horizon and boot an instance on our new subnet. We specify the appropriate network and hit launch. Initially, the VM is assigned an address from the temporary prefix belonging to the subnet. We'll see soon how later it's updated with the real address. Now I'm going to show you what our Dibbler server does when we add a router interface to our prefix delegation subnet. This router already has an external interface, which is important for this mechanism to work. We now add an internal interface to our prefix delegation enabled subnet, which triggers the prefix delegation process to begin. Almost instantly, you can see that the Dibbler server has received a prefix delegation request and has delegated an appropriate prefix to the requester. Refreshing the page, we see that the router interface has been updated with the new gateway IP of our prefix delegation subnet. And on the networks page, we can see that our subnet's been updated with a prefix matching that delegated by the Dibbler server. Our VM has also now received a real globally routable address from the appropriate prefix. Here we can see that the VM has picked up its new globally routable address. And pinging Google DNS shows us that the VM has external internet access. If we now remove the router interface, the delegated prefix will be released and acknowledged by the Dibbler server. This causes the subnet to be reset to its temporary prefix. And all instances lose their globally routable addresses. this VM no longer has internet access. And that's been a short demonstration of prefix delegation in action. Please check the description of this video for links to the code review on Gerrit, and please feel free to contact either Robert Lee or myself with questions or comments via email or IRC. Thank you.